Go ahead and shake the room. Go ahead and shake the room.
Shake it.
How about I shake the room?
What's up, everyone? Welcome back to another episode of Cooking with the God. Today, we're going to focus on making air-fried chicken sandwiches on a brioche bun. Oh my God. So, fun fact, while I was out in Texas, I somehow broke my mic. So, I'm just going to voice over these. In the next couple of episodes, you'll see me talk a little bit more while I'm working and probably a combination of the two. So, here I'm making my marinade and I'm doing 1 cup of buttermilk. And then I'm going to mix in 2 eggs, like 2 whole eggs. And then I'm going to salt and hot sauce this mix. So, I'm going to go more of a spicy route with this chicken. You can totally omit the spices if you want. That's, again, up to you. I think the spice gives it a nice little kick. It's a bit obvious I'm having a little bit too much fun here. So I wanted to talk to you guys about what I'm going to be breading my chicken with. So I'm actually going to use the cornbread mix from Kodiak. So it was interesting enough that I was going to use the flour and combine that with starch and all that other stuff that's gonna just give that extra textural crunchy component to the chicken. But I was looking in the ingredient list and this cornbread mix basically had everything that I needed in it. So I'm gonna use this and see how it turns out. Cool. So now that all that's taken care of, we're gonna go ahead and marinate this chicken. And I, again, for anything I'm marinating, I recommend marinating overnight. But if you're doing this the same day, give it 30 minutes to about 4 hours. And I know that's a lengthy gap, but again, it's gonna be dependent on how much time you actually have to give to let this chicken actually marinate. Again, that's gonna be solely up to you. So I today let this marinate for about, I think, an hour tops while I was preparing all the other ingredients as that was in the fridge just sitting. So I wasn't sure about how much I was going to need in the Kodiak cornbread mix. So I think I do about 1.5 cups here, but I think you only need 1 cup, to be honest. You're not gonna use all of the mix and you're only just gonna lightly batter it and make sure that the whole surface area of the chicken's covered. Here you'll see me over the next couple of clips add a bunch of spices to my batter. Again, at your discretion, you can use whatever seasonings you want. Here I do Cajun, paprika, cayenne, salt, pepper. Again, I wanted mine to be a little bit more on the spicy side of things. And even with as much as I put in, it still wasn't spicy enough for my liking. All right, about 1 hour has passed up at this point. So now we're going to go ahead and get this chicken into the cornbread mix and just make sure that everything's covered. So I wanna make sure that it's not wet when it comes out of the dry mix. So I wanna make sure that I'm covering the entire surface area of the chicken, front and back. All right, so a very important step's coming up. Once you make sure you're getting those nooks and crannies that literally just cover the entire surface area, you wanna make sure you have a plate out. And so you're gonna take whatever chicken you use, whether it's thighs or chicken breasts, once it comes out of the mix, the dry mix, make sure that you lay it out on a plate as I'm doing here. And once you're completely done with everything, this next step's gonna be critical into really getting your chicken crispy. All right, so this air fryer step, preheating it, you wanna make sure you do this while you're basting your chicken in the cornbread mix. So I like to let my air fryer warm up for about 5 minutes. You can do 3, that's totally up to you. This part right here is the part that I'm talking about. You wanna make sure that I'm using a can of spray and I'm spraying the entire front side of the chicken that I can see. And I'm spraying the front and the sides and I'm making sure that I don't see any dryness on it. And what I'll do then is I will lay it inside the air fryer, but typically I like to spray the inside of my air fryer so to make sure that nothing sticks on the inside. Then I'm gonna lay it down on that wet side I just sprayed. Then once that's in laid down, I'm gonna spray the top just like I did the bottom. And I'm gonna make sure that all of it is sprayed. This is a key component in making sure that you get that extra crunchiness and crispiness that we're looking for when we're making fried chicken. So while that's an air fryer to be going for about 10 minutes, I'm just gonna go ahead and toast my buns. So I lay down some butter on a pan, and what I'm going to do now is just let them sit for a little bit on a low to medium heat and get a nice little toast on it. I'm gonna go back and check in on my chicken to see how it's turning out. And it looks great, but I honestly think I want a little darker color on it to make sure it just cooks thoroughly. So I'll let that go for about another 3 minutes and it gets a nice darker shade on it. And that's what I like to see. But you want to also make sure that your chicken's always cooked through. So always check the temperature, make sure it's at 165 degrees. So this chicken turned out really well. So here I'm doing a little bit more extra work than I need to. I am putting light mayo, ketchup, hot sauce, red pepper flakes, and some other seasonings that I've been using throughout this entire process to make my own sauce for the buns. Now, again, you don't need to do this. This is just me wanting to, just to add a little finesse to the sandwich that I'm making. So what I'm doing here now is just creating two separate sandwiches. This first one is going to be a play on the Popeye's spicy chicken sandwich. I'm a fanatic when it comes to eating those, but this one's just going to be the sauce at the bottom along with the pickles and just the chicken, and both on a brioche bun. As I assemble the next sandwich, you'll see me, that's more of a classic. It'll be the tomato, leafy green, and the chicken. And now I'll probably use a fat-free dressing for that as well too. Over the next couple of clips, you're just going to see me assemble this next sandwich, as I said before, what I was going to add to it. But this video is coming to an end, you guys. I appreciate all the support. I appreciate the overwhelming request to see this sandwich made. So I went ahead and just made that video, and my mic's in today. So whenever the next couple of videos come out, I'll be talking more on the mic and showing you guys the process step by step too. But seriously, appreciate you guys. Go ahead and give this video a thumbs up, like, share, subscribe, and also put in the comments what you'd like to see next. Thank you guys. See you next time.